Hey folks, Dre'Jon Williams. Here we are in the ASB crossover session. River crossing galore. Route consists of a lot of stuff, as you can see. Got a few intersections here along the original layout, track layout here. Like the rest of them on the route. This is the only one that's delayed like that. good stuff. So, this is a progress. Then we have this railroad crossing right here. These are also safety trims. Obstacles for gate delays. Lights go off at 9 seconds. Gate delays go down at 5 seconds, of course. In real life. Okay? And then, like this one, we have this crossing right here. This is also controlled by traffic lights. You can see I use the RYY traffic lights here. These are pretty good traffic lights. These are real good traffic lights. I like them because they're like the emergency signals that you see in real life, and you can use these for these kind of, like these type of projects. So they work pretty good for these kind of crossings here. So yeah, it does pretty good. And then right here we have a traffic sign galore right here. We got all our left turn yields, we have right turn yields, we have the no U-turn signs. There's like signs all over the place in the section. Only thing I wish that Trainz or somebody would create, maybe like a street sign.
All red. I have to make
system here. This one is a 5 route 4 phases. This is the easiest one ever. This is what beginners should be using first. And these are the traffic lights you can also use in your first intersection. You know, use these basic little traffic lights. Basic 5 route 4 phases. With route 1 tapping the green, while train comes through. You got your route 3, you got turn, and then you have your route 2, your route 4. This is another basic phasing right here. This is a 7 route 4 phases. This is another easy one. You have your route 6 and 5 here, which is changing now. This also gets the zigzag red. Then you have your route 2, which is your side traffic. And your main traffic is 1 and 6. And this antenna between them, this will be your turn light. They both change at the same time. Sometimes on these traffic lights, you can get do it right, you can attack them. Believe me or not, sometimes it won't be so easy because this is green. So the only difference is if there was another cycle, maybe there was a turn on this light or something like that. But I still call it attractive. Big ass, but it is what it is. I'm not complaining about it. But, you know, playing this game for many years, you can't have me for one more time. Now we'll come to this one. This one's our next crossing, which is pretty close together. I'm trying to keep the traffic lights close. It's easy to keep the rail fan like that, where you keep an eye on all the traffic lights while you're, you know, playing on this game. This one is your basic. 9 route 5 phases. So you have your turn lights to go first on the side street, and then the straight lights. And then here is 1 and 3, 6 and 5, and 1 and 6 is the FPL when these crossings activate. Route 9 is the river crossing. Okay? And then you have this one right here. This was the second intersection I actually built after that did all the work in the middle. That crazy mess up there. This is the 8 route 5 phase. This is up all from regular turn lights, regular straight lights. Your basic. This is just your basic turn lights, straight lights and stuff. This ain't nothing like fancy like I have in the rest of the world. This is all basic. Basic stuff is easy to set up. What you can find. This is basic. This is not the basic turn lights. You have your turn lights. You have your straight lights. Straight lights here. The turn lights right there. And the way this light works, STL mode is on 1 and 3. And then there's 5 and 1 is green right now. I'm sorry, 6 and 1 is green right now. 5 is red. 3 is here and it's red. That is route 7. That is route 2. That is route 7. They change together. And their status. One goes, this one goes first, and then this one. You can get a track clearance for this one pretty good. On a good day, you can get a good track clearance for that one. Sometimes you can't, sometimes you can. And then you have your crossing light. We have a safe train crossing and two regular two-lane crossings right there. You see that just activated the hand there. Moving on, and then we have our next intersection before we get into the middle, which is a mess, by the way. We should probably come up to the intersection if you're doing that. We have US squads on the right. I know it's all on the road, but there's no other way to actually stretch it out and put it somewhere else. This is our turn. These are the squads we use at a four-way turn light system. So this session is also the five route four-phase layout as well. Basic layout, easy layout. All four. These are a little bit harder to use. Train 12, I think it's better. Train 2010 doesn't really work. The leaves are probably not going to work. There's a little fish that's going to pop up on the shade, so it's kind of hard to get the arrows and all that stuff. And then you have your regular ATLS lights. Also, face lights are easier to set up. I have the three different turn cons for left turn, and the back light is just good to place. All the good stuff.
Good. As a matter of fact, it was hard to say that the
down, turn lights change to green, and then they go yellow, red, and then one of them should be changing to double green. And as you see there. And then this one is like the replica of the other one, plus this one. Got these crossings here. Got a lot of signs. Like I said, you get the signs on the DLS. Some of these are built in. They're easy to find. They're not that hard to find. All you gotta do is look around the download space. That made sure that these second car stopped like it's supposed to. Even though they're not supposed to be on the street, but that's okay. It happens to Trainz. And then we have our just basic two route two phases where the left turn yield sign sitting there. This is for the new light, which is right here. You see a little traction like that. This is pretty cool. We have our freeway intersections. These are all the basic traffic lights. This is working on a 7 route 4 phase. This is working on a 3, on a 4, on a 5 route 4 phase. I'm sorry, on a 5 route 3 phase. Yeah, 5 route 3 phase. One of them running on a 6 route, on a 7 route 4 phase. And then we have this one. A little bit of mechanical bell going on there. I had a little bit of problems running, but it makes that tweak up a little bit. This is normal, it's Trainz. It's kind of what you get when you got a good bell sound on Trainz, and it just makes that sound. So then you just have your basic. These traffic lights are always out of sync. This is supposed to be like a real freeway, in real life freeway light traffic lights. You know, one side goes and the other side goes. And then that light changes, and that light's supposed, those two lights will change, and after that, this one's green, that one's red. They get out of sync because of the Trainz. So, I normally keep them in control, but sometimes I might just go out the way and, you know, do little things right here. This one's actually displaying track things. Actually got changed sometimes. That's pretty good. Of course, it's not going to say anything because the gates do go up, unfortunately. So they run out of sync for a bit. As you can see, they kind of fix itself when it wants to. And that's it. I showed y'all the other intersections back there. So, this is the ASB Crossover Testing. My version. The regular version, you just have a regular version. The VR train. I do have a physical one.